I'm an activist, human rights activist, and also a journalist living in Diyarbakir. And for many years I have worked on poverty and development issues in the burned and evacuated villages during the war between the PKK and Turkish states in the 90s. And I have also established different NGOs working on forced migration, paramilitary groups, education in mother tongue, reconciliation with the past, and poverty issues. And I work voluntarily also in Yazidi camps. After the ISIS attack to Yazidis, Yazidis fled to different parts of Kurdistan. And together with the Kurdish municipalities, we established camps for Yazidi people here. And I try to increase the public awareness about those Yazidi people and also the crimes that they faced, and those about the Yazidi women who were raped and sold by ISIS. And then 5 years ago, there were many things were happening, and these things compelled me to write. And I began to write as a columnist on war, peace, human rights, and war crimes in the region.
Before the curfews, before the serious human rights violations happened in this geography, between 2015 and 16, also she had the victims of the villagers in Tatvan part, for example, whose villages were distracted and evacuated by security forces during 90s. So all the villagers there, for example, in this part of district, they all know Nurcan. She spent her months and weeks there. I mean, to help the people to rebuild the village, the school, to help mainly the young women in order to survive their lives, I mean, with agriculture, for example. And then, of course, she has very nice links with these people still. I mean, she did her job there very well. But of course, because of her this fantastic energy and what she did there, now all the villagers there know Nurcan very well.
Bunların içinde ilk olarak yayınladığı kitabı anabilirim. O gün kitabı 1990'larda Van'ın Tatvan bölgesinde Kavar Havzası'nda köyleri yakılan ve köylerinden göç etmek zorunda kalan, 2000'li yıllarda tekrar köylerine dönen köylülerin hikayelerini anlatır. Bu ilk kitabı aslında çok ses getirdi. Çünkü Nurcan o kitabında kendi sesinden çok köylülerin sesini duyurmaya çalıştı. Aslında sadece o kitapta değil, bütün kitaplarında ve köşe yazılarında gördüğümüz bir şey o.
The curfew confined to their homes. Now residents in Cizre are finally able to walk freely.
Nurcan çok cesaretli, çok özverili, bütün yaşamını tehlikeye atarak, riske atarak çatışmalı alanlarda gerek Sur'da olsun, gerek Cizre'de olsun, gerek Şırnak'ta olsun, gerek Nusaybin'de olsun, gerek Bodrumlarda yakılan insanlar olsun, gerek cenazeleri çatışma bölgelerinde kalan insanlarla olan yakınlığı ve onlara olan yardımı olsun.
After the curfew was lifted, it was March 2016, I visited Cizre. It's a district, like 3 hours far away from Diyarbakir. And I witnessed a lot of war crimes done, committed by the security forces. And a few times we tried to retrieve the dead bodies. We went to those areas to take the dead bodies, but the security forces also shot at us. And we couldn't take the dead bodies. And it was the end of the January 2016. Those bodies were brought to the morgue, and they were all disintegrated. I took nearly 100 pictures about those war crimes. And then I wrote these war crimes in my column, and it created a huge backlash.
She decided to write, and then, of course, the problems had to start.
Just a few days later, the headquarters of Turkish security forces in Ankara, they censored my article unlawfully, and then they opened a court case against me.
First trial was carried on in Istanbul, 54th criminal court. This was just because she wrote an article in T24 site, and she only wrote what she saw there. Even one word she didn't add. Instead of the crimes she mentioned in this article, I mean, damaging the properties, and also these perpetrators left a letter in the kitchen of this house. All the houses were burned and destructed, and all the valuable properties were being either broken or were taken with these security forces, etc. In normal countries, in democratic countries, this is a petition to the public prosecutor office. I mean, as soon as the public prosecutor office sees such kind of article, they must call her as a witness, okay?
After 2 years, last month, the court ruled, they gave a 10-month prison, but then they ruled to suspend the verdict, meaning that if I don't commit the same crime, the crime is humiliating the Turkish security forces, within the next 5 years, so there will be no punishment.
Nurcan, o gözaltı sürecinde de hiç haklarından taviz vermedi. Yani Nurcan'ın bence en önemli yanlarından birisi de o, haklarına sahip çıkması. Yani hem kendi haklarına, hem en yakın çevresinin haklarına, tabii hem hani Kürt halkının haklarına.
Yani hepimizin hayatını tabii ki o kadar girmiş.
Bu sahip çıkışta da sesini mümkün olduğunca yüksek çıkartması, yazılarıyla bunu aktarması, köşe yazılarıyla aktarması gerçekten az bulunur bir şey bu coğrafyada diyeyim.
It is really, really hard. You know, it is hard to be a journalist in Turkey, but it is really very, very hard to be a Kurdish journalist in Turkey. I had some court cases and some other investigations about my social media posts and articles. Just last January, after just one day after the Turkish offensive in Afrin launched, they detained me. And because of my social media posts about the peace and about my social media posts, which shows that I'm against the war, and I criticize the war policies of Turkish government.
Everyone is terrorist. If you criticize, you are a terrorist.
They, you know, enter my home, which they knew that there are two small children inside, and like 20 special operations team with Kalashnikovs, you know, they entered my home and they took me in front of the children.
It was very frightening to see her treated like that.
I was blamed with spreading terrorist propaganda and calling for, you know, action. And then now in May I have a court hearing. And the prosecutor, as I said, blamed me also to encourage hatred and hostility. it's really ironic.
She's someone who has been targeted because of her critical writings and because of her work in defense of human rights, for her human rights activism, which has always been about defending the rights of ordinary people and telling the stories of ordinary people who have lost their homes, their loved ones, and have had their lives devastated.
It seems that, you know, they are trying to stop me to writing with all these bans and with all this pressure, and they are trying to tie me up, you know, with all these meaningless, really they are meaningless court cases and bans. you know.
grubuz Türkiye'de, çünkü çok zordur bu mücadeleyi yürütmek. Bu mücadeleyi yürütmek başlı başına bir risktir. Yaşam hakkı tehliken de dahi vardır. Özgürlüğünden mahrum kalma tehliken %100'dür. Cezaevine atılırsın, tutuklanırsın ya da ailene, çoluk çocuğuna zarar verilebilecek bir durumdur insan hakları mücadelesi vermek Türkiye'de.
When it comes to the defense of human rights, you know, there's lots of defenders have been prosecuted for terrorism offenses without having committed anything that could or should be described as terrorism.
The things that are not a crime become a crime in Turkey, you know. Even to say peace, to demand peace, can make you as a terrorist. So all of us is terrorists in the eyes of this government. And all the media shows us, show the people who want peace as terrorists. You know, academics who want peace, they are terrorists. Students who want peace, they are terrorists. Like activists and journalists like us who write the war crimes, they say that we are terrorists. So, you know, it's a country of lots of terrorists, consists of academics, journalists, intellectuals, writers.
At a time when the media is really so restricted in Turkey, this kind of activism, which is like citizen journalism in a way, has a particular relevance. And she was really always writing about rights issues, but bringing it to the level of, you know, what happens to women, children, families in times of conflict.
Turkey is a big prison for people who want peace, who want human rights, who want democracy, who want justice. It's really, really, really a very big prison. People like us who demand peace, we can easily declared as terrorists, and we can be killed, we can be put in prison, and we forced to leave the country.
Ama bunun içinde hiçbir zaman kendi içine dönmeden dışarıya ezilenlerin, hakları yenilenlerin sorunlarını yüksek sesle anlatabilen ve oldukça baskı görmesine rağmen bundan hiçbir zaman vazgeçmeyen bir insan. Bu nitelikleriyle bu ödülü aslında fazlasıyla hak ettiğini düşünüyorum.
I think Nurcan will continue to do that work. She believes so strongly in it. But it has put her at particular risk in this period.
Yeah, it is really not easy to live in Diyarbakır, also to hold on to hope still. We suffer, but we also struggle. These are together.